welcome to Friendly Hour. Now, a wee bit of news. This is going to be the last online Friendly Hour. For a while. We're not quite sure what's happening at the moment, with big changes in the church and big changes in the regulations. I'm very much planning to get Friendly Hour back in the hall in real life, back together again in September. So what we're going to do is we're going to take the summer off. Recharge our batteries. I think we all need to do that, don't we? Revitalise ourselves. Look at the programme again. And get going again in September in real life. Having said that, as you know, we live in strange times. Anything can happen. But that's the plan. So let's think about that. It's going to be good. I'm just longing to see you all in real life again. So today's programme, well, we're thinking about, do you remember when we were all at school, which was not yesterday? Do you remember what happened when we broke up for the summer holidays? I can. And if you come from Irvin, you'll remember too. And I'm going to talk about that a wee bit later on. But Peter's going to sing to us. We're going to have our quiz. It's going to be really good. So let's enjoy it all together. And look forward to the day, and hopefully it's very soon now, where we're all going to get back together under one roof, round the same table, tea, cakes, the lot. So, let's enjoy ourselves. Let's go right on to the sing-along. Breaking up from school for the summer holidays. Do you remember it? Oh, I do. Say what, 1956, 1957, that kind of time? I was at Montgomery Street School in Irvine. Now, and it, to me, looking back on it, it happened, you know, a lot of times, breaking up from school. It couldn't have done. It just seemed like an awful lot. I think it was because they were always the same. First of all, you had to get your jotters all sorted out. You had to have your marks for that year all sorted. You had them taken home for your parents to look at. You got your report card with good, bad or indifferent on it. Then it was sports day. Now, I don't know about you. I was not a sporting person. I was happy to stand and mind the cardigans while other people ran up and down, jumped over bars and did things like that. That wasn't my thing. I tried to hide as much as possible. Three-legged races, no. Sack race, the very thought. Wheelbarrow race, the relay race. And to be perfectly honest, nobody ever picked me for their athletics team. And I don't blame them at all, because I just wasn't into it. I was a bookworm. I read. Everybody else was out there in the sunshine. I was reading a book. It was all manner of things like that. And then the next thing, and this is the thing that really sticks in my mind, going to church. And I remember it as being the old parish church in Irvine, because I know it was a long way, and I know we crossed the bridge, which was there in those days, and we walked two by two. And to me, shorter legs, it seemed like a very long way. Then we filed in, and we were packed into pews, because every school in the town was there. All at the same time, there must have been thousands of us packed into pews. And I think it was the old parish, because I remember the marble plaques on the wall. So that must be what it is. And the other thing I remember is singing, "Summer suns are glowing over land and sea." And we sang that every single time. Can't remember a word of whatever sermon there was, but I can remember the teachers who couldn't have enjoyed themselves at all, because all they could do was going shh, shh. And all the wee boys were dropping their marbles on the floor and then getting off their seats and going under the pews to get their marbles back. You know, it was that kind of do. But I remember it well. And I also remember that we were off for 10 weeks. Now, 10 weeks these days would involve parents in an absolute fortune of money finding things for you to do. But no such thing in those days. You're told to get out the house and come back at meal times. And we went fishing for minnows with jam jars. We just went roaming about in a way that would get our mothers reported to the social services these days. And we just did things. We built wee dens. And we planted seeds that we pulled off of flowers. And do you remember the rose petal perfume? Well, that was terrible. But we always had great hopes of it. We kept doing it. We found dogs to play with. We found other kids to play with. We just got on with it. Some people went berry picking up to Gowrie, and I always wanted to do that and was never allowed to. But the 10 weeks soon passed and another school year started. And it's a wee bit like what we're doing at the moment. We're having a break for summer, but we'll be starting again. We'll start again in September. As I've said, hope so. But it's a funny world we live in, but we will do our very best, because there's nothing like getting together. So school holidays, that's what mine were like. And sometimes we went away, because my mother and father were both Welsh, so we had plenty of relatives in Wales to go to. My father worked in the railway, so we had free tickets. Wonderful. Wonder what yours were like. If you can remember anything unusual about your breaking up in your school days, do tell us about it.
Well, thank you very much, Lynn, for that wonderful reminder of school sports days. How I hated those days. I never enjoyed sports days at all because I was either last or on my bottom, and usually both. So when Anne asked me to look for a poem for Friendly Hour, I found one that matched me to perfection. So here it is. It's called Bottoms Up by Alan Balter. I was looking around for a new winter sport, something rigorous but not a dangerous sort. A good friend of mine suggested to me, if you can walk, you can cross-country ski. So I shopped around at a sporting goods store. It was a nice discount I was looking for. Soon I found a pair that didn't cost a lot, and I got a lesson right on the spot. The very next day, don't you know, the ground was covered with 8 inches of snow. So I packed my skis into the van and headed to the golf course, a sensible plan. Others like me had the same thing in mind, so I strapped on my skis and waited in line. The weather was great, the conditions superior, but in no time at all, I was on my posterior. I dusted myself off and started to glide, just as two experts jostled me on my side. I lost concentration and didn't see a bump, and there I was again, flat on my rump. Never discouraged, I stood tall once more, started to feel the perspiration pour, but just as I felt I was starting to get it, back on my derriere, should I forget it? Never, I said to myself with resolve, this is a puzzle I can solve. And just then I steered right into a tree and landed sans dignity right on my knee. Two ladies came over to help me up. I was whining now like an orphaned pup. I'm sorry, ladies, to be so troublesome, but would you mind rubbing my aching bum? They left in a hurry, as you might think, actually quicker than a wink. I made it home with a sore keister, hoping I'll feel better come next Easter. Next day I saw my good friend at work and squelched the urge to call him a jerk. And while removing our lunches from the office fridge, I explained to my plans to take up bridge. I hope you found that funny. And now, here with your favourite quiz is Anne.
Good afternoon, everybody. A very warm welcome to you. And it is a very warm welcome because summer has appeared out of nowhere. It was at least about 15 degrees yesterday now in Scotland. That's pretty much a heat wave. And so we've all been busy, I'm sure, in the gardens. I know I have. There's been a lot to do. I've had plants overwintering, so I've been gradually accustoming them to being outside and putting them back in at night. Hopefully I can leave them out overnight soon. And there's lots of stuff happening at the minute, as you know. We're beginning to open up. We can go to more shops soon. We're meeting family and friends. We'll be able to go for a coffee soon as well. And with stuff in the garden and stuff happening at church going back on the 16th, there's a lot going on. So as Lynn says, we've decided that it's a good time to take a wee break and just get ourselves together. And we'll be back with you in the autumn in some shape or form when we realise and get accustomed to all the changes that have been made at present. So this is your last quiz for a wee while, and I'd just like to thank you for joining me on Friendly Hour and taking part in the quizzes. I hope you've enjoyed them as much as I've enjoyed doing them. Now, your last one is, it's all names. The songs have all got a name in them. Might be a man's name, might be a woman's name. So I'm going to give you a wee minute, get your pen and your paper ready and get your thinking caps on. There's quite a range of from very old to quite modern, so you'll need to think quite hard about it. And I'll be back with you just in a couple of seconds with question one and two. Okay, so here we go with question one. Okay, I'll let you write that one down. And here's question two. Those two. I'll be back in a second with three and four. Okay, here we go with number three. Two, and I'll be back in a second with your last two. Now, number five. They've been quite easy so far, but here's the one. You know, I like to give you one that's a bit trickier, and this is it. So, see how you get on. I'll give you a wee clue. This one's a man's name. That may help, okay? Good luck. Let me know if you get it. I love when you get the harder ones. You'll be pleased to know that this one's, well, I think it's easy, but then I know the answers. Here we go, number six. Couple of seconds actually with the answers this time, so double check, see if you've got them all. You might have remembered one now at the beginning that you didn't get as we were going through, so I'll see you in a minute. Okay, here we go with your answers. Now, number one, was Charmaine, and it was the Bachelors. You know the three Irish... Oh, I'm going back some now. The Bachelors. Three Irish guys. One was called Date, one was called Con, and I can't remember what the other one was called. So, number one was Charmaine. Number two, you'll remember from your childhood, probably, like, really way back, and that was Clementine. Oh, my darling, Clementine. Now, number three, bit more up to date, 70s, 80s, Gilbert O'Sullivan song called Claire. Number four was a Nat King Cole song called Mona Lisa. Now, number five, the trickier one. It was a Judy Garland song. Now, I couldn't remember who sang it. I just had to Google that, actually, to find out that it was Judy Garland. And I have no idea how I know that song. But anyway, I do. And it was I'm Just Wild About Harry. So Harry was the name there, okay? And the last one. Now, I think most folk would know this one. And it was the title song from the musical, and there was a film also, and it was Mame. Now, Mame in the film was Lucille Ball. Do you remember her? I think she was married to Denny Arnaz. Would I be right? Let me know if I'm wrong. But in the stage musical, it was Angela Lansbury that played Mame. So there you go. So Charmaine, Clementine, Claire, Mona Lisa, Harry, and Mame. And that's all your answers. Now, we're taking the summer off. And just to kind of celebrate that, I'm going to hand you over to Peter. And Peter's going to sing you a song about the summer holidays that probably most of us are not going to be able to go on. However, it'll be nice to remember ones that we've been on and hopefully plan something for the future. So, Peter, do your best on Cliff Richard's famous song, Summer Holiday.
We're all going on a summer holiday, no more working for a week or two. Fun and laughter on our summer holidays, no more worries for me and you. For a week or two, we're going where the sun shines brightly, we're going where the sea is blue. You've seen it in the movies, now let's see if it's true. Everybody has a summer holiday, doing things they always wanted to. So we're going on a summer holiday to make our dreams come true for me and you. We're going where the sun shines brightly, we're going where the sea is blue. Seen it in the movies, now let's see if it's true. We're all going on a summer holiday, doing things we always wanted to. So we're going on a summer holiday to make our dreams come true for me and you. For me and you. For me and you. Have a lovely holiday.
thank you very much for that, Peter. That was lovely. Summer holidays. My goodness, what happened last year? An absolute disaster. Nobody could get any summer holidays. And the weather's been glorious this past week. It sets you thinking about summer holidays, doesn't it? About lying in the sun and sunbathing on the beach, the waves lapping. Oh, glorious. And here's hoping that this year we might get something towards maybe the end of the year, maybe the summer, but we'll keep our fingers crossed. So just to tease you a little, we've come up with a wee quiz based on popular summer holiday destinations and famous landmarks from those destinations. So what we'd like you to do is look at the pictures, guess the famous landmark and where they are, and I'll come back just shortly and give you the answers. So have fun and good luck. So how did you get on with the quiz? Did you get them all? So here's the answers. Number one, the Eiffel Tower. Number two, the Empire State Building. Number three, the Vatican in Rome. Number four, Buckingham Palace. Number five, Sydney Opera House. Number six, the Taj Mahal. Number seven, the Leaning Tower of Pisa. And number eight, the Pyramids of Egypt. So well done if you got them all. And fingers crossed that we'll get a summer holiday this year. Take care. Speak to you soon.
I'm sure you all recognise that music that Anne's just played. It's a theme tune from that great film, Chariots of Fire, concerning the Olympic Games in the 1920s. And one of the main threads of the film was Eric Liddell, the man who wouldn't run on a Sunday. Eric had been brought up by parents who were missionaries to China, and they taught him that it was wrong to do anything like that on the Sabbath day. And he stuck to his guns and he didn't, although he was tipped for gold. Instead, he ran on another day, a weekday, in a race that he wasn't trained for. And he still won. He still was the gold medalist. He himself trained for the ministry, went back to China as a missionary. was captured by the Japanese and ended up in a prisoner of war camp, where in early 1945 he died. But he was such a man. He was such a steadfast man, kind of man you don't see very much of these days. So the quotation this time is something that he said. And I think you'll agree with me, a man like that, you've really got to listen to his words. So the words are going to be coming up. Just look at them. Take them into your heart and realise where they came from. They came from someone who'd won gold at the Olympics and died in a prisoner of war camp and was true to his God and his religion and his convictions to the very end. Have a look. Take it into your heart. Here's your cause for thought.
Someone like you, bows so good and true, and like leave it all behind. Go and find some place that's known to God alone. Just a thought to call my own. You'll find perfect peace, your joy shall never cease. There beneath the timeless sky could be the sweet little nest somewhere in the west. Let the rest of the world go by. When the sun in the morning beats over the hill and kisses the roses round my windowsill, then my heart fills with gladness as I hear the thrill of the birds in the treetops on Mockingbird Hill. Tra-la-la, trill-lee-dee, it gives me a thrill to wake up in the morning to the Mockingbird Trill. Tra-la-la, trill-lee-dee, there's peace and goodwill. You're as welcome as the flowers on Mockingbird Hill. When it's late in the evening, I climb up the hill and survey my kingdom while everything's still. Only me and the sky and the old whippoorwill. You're as welcome back home up on a Mockingbird Hill. Tra-la-la, trilly. It gives me a thrill to wake up in the morning to the Mockingbird Trill. Tra-la-la, trill-lee-dee, peace and goodwill. You're as welcome as the flowers on Mockingbird Hill. With someone like you, a bow so good and true, I'd like to leave it all behind and go and find some place that's known to God alone. Just a spot to call our own. You'll find perfect peace where joy shall never cease. Out there beneath the kindless sky, you'll build a sweet little nest somewhere in the west. Let the rest of the world go by.
Well, wasn't that good? It was fun. It's so lovely to see Peter. And I know that he's going to come and play for us when we're all back in real life in the hall. As I say, to be announced. But I'm hopefully seeing the middle of September. And we just thank you all, wherever you are, for having been kept us company all this long, over a year now we've been online. And we invite you to join us again. If you don't live in Arvin, we're very, very easy to find. There's a bus stop within 2 minutes walk of us from whichever direction you're coming in. So we hope to see you. Get in touch with us. Tell us you'd like to come and we'll give you proper directions. But let's just look forward to that. Let's look forward to getting back to a wee bit of normality. And let's just wish each other well. May God bless us. With abundant health, with true happiness, with peaceful minds, and the joyful expectations of a brighter future, and the hope of a life freely lived. Until we meet again, take care, and bye-bye for now.